So in the last episode, we were able to create an API endpoint to handle post requests. And in this episode, I want us to test this API endpoint using Postman. The first thing is to open your browser and visit postman.com/downloads. And then you can download Postman for your OS, for Windows. And if you are using Mac, just scroll at the bottom here and you can download for Mac or Linux. Once you download Postman and install it, just open it and you land to a page like this one. At the top here, open a new tab. And this is where you can test the endpoints. So you can test a GET request, POST request, PUT, PATCH, and DELETE. So these are the CRUD operations. And let's start by testing a GET endpoint, which we created earlier in my index.js file here. You'll see that we created an API endpoint to handle GET request. So when we test this endpoint, we should get a welcome message, welcome to our to-do's API. So now let's test this endpoint. Right here, we type the URL, which is http://, and then we are running our server on localhost :5000, and then this is the home page. When we send this request, we should get that welcome message. So send, and there we go, welcome to our to-do's API. So this endpoint is working okay. Now let's test our post endpoint, which we created on our to-dos file. Okay, so when I come to the to-dos.js, this is where we created our post endpoint, and we can test this endpoint with Postman. So the first thing is to enter the URL, which is http://, but right now we'll add something at the end here, because at our path in index.js we included /API/todos. So I'll copy API/todos, and then in my URL here I'll add it here. And then we need to send something to the body of the request. So right here we have body, and then click row, and we'll be sending our data in JSON format. So here at the drop down, select JSON. And I'll enter sample data here in form of an object. The first property is name, and the name can be our first to do. And then the other property was author, and the author can be Charles. And then is complete, so this was a boolean, so it must be either true or false. So right here it'll say false, and I can enter these three properties, although we had more than this. So if we come to our to-do's schema, you'll see that only the name was required. So if we omit these other properties, it should not throw an error. So we have a name, an author, and is complete. Date will be added automatically because we included a default date, and we can omit the UID. So now when we send this request, we should get a to-do back, because in our endpoint, let me show you, once we save our to-do, we are also sending the same to-do to the user once it have already been saved. Okay, so let's send this request, submit, and perfect. Now we are getting a to-do back, and you can see now it have additional values, because this is now coming from the database. We have a date, which was automatically added by default. We have an ID, which is a string of characters. This was added automatically by MongoDB. And then we have what we included in the body of the request. Name, author is complete, and also we have a version for this particular to do. Now when we go to MongoDB, we should see this data. Okay, so I'll open my browser and then go to MongoDB Atlas. Now right here you can click collections, and you should see that a database was created automatically called todo app. And when I come here, this is the data that we just added: name, author, and is complete. Now where did this name come from? This is the name of the database. Remember in our connection string, in our .env file, we had included the name of our database here, todo app. So this is the name that was added. Now let's test whether this validation works, where we set a minimum of 3 and maximum of 200, and we made the name to be required. So I'll come back to Postman and I'll omit the name. Let's submit, and now we should get an error: todo validation failed, name path name is required. Now let's include a name but with fewer characters than 3. So I revert this and delete something. Only include 2 characters. When I submit this, we should also get an error: todo validation failed, name path name is shorter than the minimum allowed length, which is 3. So you can see that our Mongoose validation is working. Now in the next video, we will look at further data validation using Joy.